So, student, today we are going to discuss about the subatomic particles. Subatomic particles means as atom is indivisible, but atom also contain indivisible particles. Somebody is in waiting room. Wait a second, beta. So, as we know that atom is indivisible particle. But atom also contain three types of subatomic particles, okay? And these three particles are, so here we have atom and first particle or subparticle of the atom is called as beta electron. Electron was discovered by Sir J.J. Thomson. Then we have second, it is the proton. Okay, the conformation of proton was like the prediction of proton was given by the scientist name called Goldstein, but it was confirmed by Rutherford. Okay, and third, we have neutron. A neutron was discovered by James Chadwick. Okay, so now we'll discuss like their charge, where they are located, okay, their relative mass and their actual mass. So here we have electron. It generally represents by E negative like this, okay, and it always revolving around the nucleus. So we know nucleus is positively charged and it is present at the center, and around it nucleus, around the nucleus electrons are revolving in different orbit. Okay, so these orbits are nothing but the energy level around the nucleus. Okay, then the charge on electron is minus one. We are just considering it is minus one charge, but actual charge on electron is, it is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, and that much of charge we are considering one unit.
Sir, it will be minus. Sir, it will be minus 1.6, right?
Its magnitude is minus, beta.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, its magnitude is minus, but charge is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Okay, and its mass is about, see that 1840 is around 2000. Okay, so if we will divide the mass of see, it is almost 2000 times less than the mass of proton. Okay? Understood?
Yes, sir.
And actual mass of electron is 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 28 kg. It is given in kg here. Okay. Next, we have subatomic particles called proton. So you have to like remember these values. Okay, it is 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 28 kg. Okay, it is okay, mass, sir. Actual yes, mass sir. Of one electron. Okay, now proton. So proton is represented by P positive. It is represented by P positive. And it is present at the center of atom called nucleus. Then it have charge. It is magnitude of the like value is the same as electron, but its magnitude is different. Like charge, it is considered as positive because it cancels the negative charge of electron. Okay, but it is having charge as similar as the charge on one electron, and which is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. And it is considered as positive one charge because it is opposing charge of electron. Okay, that's why like charge on electron is equals to charge on proton. Okay, but their magnitude is different. Okay, but their charge is same. Only magnitude means the sign is different. It is having negative and it is having positive charge like this. That's why they cancels each other. That's why they cancels each other charge. Okay. The relative mass is considered as beta one atomic mass unit. It is one atomic mass unit. It is AMU. Or it is also called as unified atomic mass. Okay, it is also called as unified atomic mass. But its actual mass is 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 24 kg. It is also given in kg here, kilogram. Now we have a neutron. Yes.
Sir, I logged through another device. Sir.
Okay. I think no one is in waiting room now.
No, sir. Okay.
Next. Then we have neutron. Neutron is represented by N0. N0 means neutral particle. Okay. It is again present along with proton at the center of atom called nucleus. It has no charge on it, but its mass is approximately similar to the mass of proton. Okay, it is approximate have equal mass as proton, which is 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 24 kg. Okay, everyone, this is all about the subatomic particles of atom.
Okay, done. Sir.
So I want you have to take a screenshot for that. Okay. So here, like, you know, we have the center of atom. So here the proton and neutron, they collectively present at the center of atom. Okay.
And sir, they are called nucleons when they are present at the center.
Yeah, they are like protons and neutrons collectively are known as nucleons. Why? Because they form nucleus. Okay, due to presence of proton and neutron, there is existence of nucleus in an atom. That's why they are called as nucleons. Okay, everyone.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
So one doubt. Sir, because we can say the electrons charge and the mass of electron and proton are the same.
Mm-hmm.
And you said that nucleons are the same. I mean, neutrons are the same, similar mass as proton.
Mm-hmm.
So do they have the similar mass as electron?
The mass of neutron is equal to mass of proton plus two electrons, right?
See, slightly, very, like, it is negligible.
Yeah. Yes, like two electrons extra mass is there in neutron.
Yes. So we can write here, mass of neutron is slightly, it is delta, it is del. Delta slightly greater than the mass of proton. See, it is the representation for the slightly greater. Or instead of symbol, we can write here, mass of neutron is slightly greater than mass of proton, but it is not been considering because it is very negligible.
Okay? Yes, sir, it's negligible, sir.
Yes. Okay. So here we have three questions. Question number one. Why is the relative mass of the electron is taken as negligible? Because it has a very, very, very less mass as compared to proton and neutron. That's why the mass of electron is being negligible. Give the actual mass of the electron and proton in kg. So here it is given in kg. What is nucleon? So proton and neutron collectively called as nucleons. Okay, so any doubt beta here?
No, sir.
No, so no, take a screenshot, then we'll move further. Hania, any doubt beta?
No, sir.
Ritvik?
No, sir.
Him, Sai?
Sir.
I have one more like student here in offline classes. His name is Himgiri Sai. So I was just about to like say his name, Himgiri Sai. Okay. Yogesh? No, Vivek.
Yes, sir. No.
Okay. So now we will discuss the atomic number and mass number. Okay, it's really quite easy. So I'm just explaining here only. See, in an atom, number of electron are always equals to number of proton. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So you can consider the number of electron or number of proton. Their number is equals to the atomic number. So I'm writing here atomic number.
I've got one doubt.
Uh-huh.
Sir, in my classes, I have heard that since we electrons can be lost or given, then we can't assume either yes. electron or proton.
Yes, we have to like consider electrons number only.
So, do you mean protons?
No, see, suppose we have beta here, sodium. So, we know sodium have atomic number 11. That means sodium have 11 electron and 11 proton.
But since an atom can lose again electrons, isn't it like we should consider the protons, although they're same?
No, we will consider the whatever the number is changing from, we have to consider only electrons number. So I'm just discussing here, wait a second. Okay. So when sodium, so its atomic number is 11, so we can consider number of electron or number of proton. But when sodium loses electron, okay, having 11 electron, when sodium loses one electron, will form sodium positive ion by loss of one electron. Is it? So sodium will have then 8 atomic number. Is it? Because sodium positive ion have 10 electron and we are writing its electronic configuration as 2 and 8. 2 and 8. So we can't say it is atom. It is now ion, sodium ion. Okay. But in atom, okay, they are neutral, then we have to consider either the number of electron or number of proton.
Okay, sir, understood.
Next. So, okay. So, what is atomic number? Atomic number is the number of proton. So, let me write here, number of proton. Or number of electron. Okay, so what is atomic number? It is nothing but the number of proton or number of electron is called as beta atomic number. Is considered as atomic number. Is considered as atomic number. Okay. Now, what is atomic mass number? So, atomic mass number is nothing but
number of nucleons.
Yes, number of nucleon means number of proton and number of
neutrons. Massum is the sum of nucleons and neutrons and protons.
Yes, someone was saying something.
Sir, I was saying it's a sum of the protons and neutrons in the nucleus.
Yes. Atomic mass number equals to number of protons plus number of neutrons. Okay, present in center of atom called nucleus. So wherever like all the proton and electron are present in nucleus, their sum is equals to atomic mass number. Easy?
Yes, sir.
That's
yes, all. Sir.
So again, take us. One more thing. Atomic number is represented by Z. Okay. And atomic mass number is represented by capital A. Okay. So what is atomic number now? Atomic number is nothing but the number of electron or proton present in an atom is called as its atomic number. What is atomic mass number? The number of nucleons or the sum of number of protons and neutrons present in the nucleus of an atom is called as atomic mass number. Okay, very easy.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so again take a screenshot here. Done, sir. Okay, so here we have completed the electron, proton and neutron part. So just do repeat and just tell me any doubt you have here.